Another family is grieving tonight after Sydney's flood emergency claimed the life of a 68-year-old man this morning in the city's southwest. His body was found inside a submerged van in Cobbitty to the north of Camden. The discovery follows dozens of other rescues across Sydney's southwest and northwest. Thousands remain under evacuation orders in those areas. And with Warragamba Dam continuing to spill, many people downstream are in for another anxious night.
Emergency crews venture out into dangerous floodwaters. Tragically, this isn't a rescue, but a retrieval of a man's body. The 68-year-old was reported missing just before 8 a.m. His submerged van was spotted shortly after. The delicate operation to recover his body ended just before 1 p.m., with Polair, police divers and the SES all pitching in to help. It was on this same stretch of road where just 4 weeks ago this B-double was stranded in rapidly rising floodwaters. The driver was lucky to escape in time. Further down the river in Camden, even seasoned locals weren't prepared for what hit them.
In 1978, we had a flood that is bigger than this one. And the workshop I worked in went underwater, but this is the first time I've seen it come up three times so close together.
This one came up the fastest. Yesterday I only saw the water at the backyard at 12 o'clock, a bit after 12, and by 2:30 it was in the garage.
Some scrambled to save what they could, but even the best of intentions couldn't beat the downpour.
So I go, there might be a chance of saving my van back there. Pretty much swam to the van. Power went on, but it wouldn't crank, so I thought, nah, it's gone. It's a brand new van.
Businesses barely back on their feet after last month's deluge forced to shut their doors once more before the cleanup begins all over again.
I feel sorry for these local businesses and the servo. Yeah, it'd break your heart. They've been working hard cleaning up and then it's come up again out of nowhere.
The last floods have meant weeks of lost work for the local sports club as repairs were carried out. They were only just finished yesterday when the flooding returned.
And gyprock walls were all damaged. Well, yesterday they just finished repairing the gyprock walls and now they've all been wet again.
Exhausted but resilient, this is a job residents hope to not have to repeat anytime soon. Alice Hogg, 4 News First.